Now let us study the structure of ovaries in detail. Ovary is lined by a cuboidal epithelium. This epithelium is known as germinal epithelium. You know why this is called germinal epithelium? Because it keeps on dividing and it forms follicles. Follicles, these are the cells which are formed by this epithelium. Below germinal epithelium, there is a connective tissue layer, and this is called tunica albuginea. The entire inner space of the ovary is called stroma. The outer part of the stroma is called cortex, and the inner part is called medulla. At the time of birth, human ovary is having many primary follicles. These follicles, they are in lakhs in number. And after birth, a large number of these follicles, either during the embryonic development or just immediately after the birth, a large number of these follicles are destroyed. And this phenomena is known as follicular atresia. Now, whatever follicles are left in the ovaries, their numbers will not increase throughout the life of that female. And these follicles are in the growth phase. A primary follicle is the primary oocyte, which are surrounded by the many granulosa cells. And granulosa cells are nothing but the follicular cell. Let me show you. This is the primary follicle. In primary follicle, you can see in the center, there is oocyte. This oocyte is surrounded by the follicle cells. Now, as these follicles mature, these get surrounded by many other layers of granulosa cells. Now, primary follicle will get changed into secondary follicle, then it into tertiary follicles. When it is maturing, a cavity start appearing in this. You can see in the beginning there is no cavity, but when it is maturing, then there is a cavity inside this. This maturation of the primary follicle into a mature follicle or a graafian follicle occurs only after puberty. At the time of the birth, they are all in primary follicle stage. So its maturation into secondary, tertiary, graafian, it will occur only after puberty. And only one follicle in either of the ovary will get matured in the graafian follicle. It is not that many follicles simultaneously are maturing into graafian follicle. No, at a time only one. So this is a very big difference between the gamete formation in case of male and in female. In male, at a time, millions of sperms are formed, and that can be even on the daily basis. But in case of female, in one ovarian cycle, and the duration of one ovarian cycle is one lunar cycle, that is 28 days. So in 28 days, only one follicle will get mature into graafian follicle, and that too only in one of the ovary. So this is the mature follicle. Just now I am going to tell you the structure of this graafian follicle in detail. Now when this burst, it is going to release the ovum. Exactly, ovum is written here. This is secondary oocyte. And then this ruptured follicle or the ruptured graafian follicle, this known as the corpus luteum. This is the corpus luteum. If pregnancy is there, then this corpus luteum is maintained for some time. Otherwise, if there is no fertilization, no pregnancy, then this corpus luteum also breaks down and it forms corpus albicans. This is the structure of the Graafian follicle. I have shown you here. You can see that there are many layers of follicle cells here. These are known as granulosa cells. And inside this, there is a cavity. This cavity is called antrum. And inside this antrum, there is a fluid that is called liquor folliculi. Inside this antrum and the fluid, this secondary oocyte surrounded by many cells is floating here. These cells that surround this secondary oocyte is called corona radiata. And inside corona radiata, you can see a dark layer. This is zona pellucida. This secondary oocyte, this is attached to the granulosa cells present outer side by a group of cell. This group of cell is called cumulus oophorus. And this Graafian follicle is behaving as an endocrine structure also. It is secreting the hormone estrogen. Estrogen, we have done in earlier classes that it is responsible for the secondary sex characteristic in female. A very important secondary sex characteristic is the beginning of menstrual cycle that we have to study in detail. When Graafian follicle bursts and it releases ovum, the remaining structure is yellow in color, and that is why this is known as the corpus luteum. This corpus luteum again behave as an endocrine structure, and this secrete an hormone that is known as progesterone. This progesterone is responsible for maintenance of the pregnancy, or you can say the maintenance of the thickening of the endometrium of uterus. However, if fertilization doesn't occur, then this will also disintegrate, and the remaining structure is now known as the corpus albicans that slowly disappear. Now just look at this structure. This is the primary oocyte surrounded by just a single layer of the follicular cells called the granulosa cells. Now more and more cells will be added to this, and now this primary follicle will get changed into secondary follicle and then into tertiary follicle. You can see the white color layer around this ovum that is called zona pellucida. Now the cavities start appearing in this cavity. There is a fluid that I have informed you earlier also, follicular fluid called the liquor folliculi. Now this is the mature follicle showing you a fully developed antrum here. Now the Graafian follicle bursts, and this is releasing the secondary oocyte surrounded by the corona radiata. Now the remaining structure is the corpus luteum, and this is